on Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, or Facebook. In order to properly pay homage to this factory of food-related content, we'll be doing our best to make this video as concise as possible, which will likely be difficult given our track record. Through talking about the audio and visual design, personality, and underlying concepts, we hope to give you an idea of why Tasty works. Some pretext before we jump in, Tasty currently has over 250 million combined followers. So, how have they accomplished this? Well, if we look at the audio and visual design of what is arguably their trademarks to how specific directions in the recipe are carried out, make note of the knife's positioning as it cuts through things or the circular motions of the stirring. However, while there's certainly a great deal of intention in the placement and movements, there's also a rather organic messiness the creators behind Tasty like to apply to each shot. By towing the line between perfection and a slight DIY offness, the content maintains a degree of relatability or realness. The next key point is constant motion. Just from watching these few clips, it's easy to see that these videos have no downtime. There's always some kind of motion on the screen, whether it be the general preparation of the recipe or the shifts to close-up shots. In order to consistently catch your attention as you scroll through a feed and keep you watching, these videos are designed to have a fast-paced, stimulating flow. Following this, we have Tasty's focus on reveal shots and general oddly satisfying type content. Because so much of the video is a build-up to a view of the completed meal, Tasty often relies on visually appealing process shots and end-of-video cross-sections to really hammer in the beauty of the food. Next, it's important to emphasize Tasty's use of food imagery lighting, which is something mentioned in our Hot Ones video that seems to be present throughout most food content. Because of this lighting, the colors of the food appear bright and fresh. Of course, these colors are often grounded with the darker, earthier tones of kitchen equipment, and holistically this works to bring attention to the food and build a colorful and optimistic aesthetic, which is seen further in their branding. Additionally, this bright color scheme is paired with clear white text used for recipe instructions, usually centered or vertically aligned. Again, this contributes to the optimistic design as it emphasizes how easily one can prepare these dishes. Finally, we have some general notes on the audio design, which is incredibly simple as it's just uplifting high BPM music, which pairs well with the speedy preparation of these dishes. In totality, the audio is used to emphasize the quick, easy-to-create nature of these recipes. Also, it's important to note that most Tasty videos include this soundbite at the end.
Oh, yes!
Which is another branding technique associating the audio stimulus with the style of content, and also giving beloved BuzzFeed employee Andrew a chance to shine. Still, since an estimated 85% of video content consumed on Facebook is done in silence, the majority of Tasty's success hinges on the visual aspects of their content. Moving on to the personality section, there's not really any personality present. In fact, the only inklings of humanity are the hands you see making things. However, I think this is deliberate. By only showing the POV shot of someone creating the meal, the viewer is encouraged to project themselves into the video and imagine it is them preparing this meal with ease, which in turn makes these videos even more addicting as it gives the viewer the sensation that they're actually preparing the dish or at least learning how to. Beyond this, the only other personality is the overarching Tasty brand entity, which is meant to be viewed as a sort of homey, clean food instructional channel. However, emphasis on clean, as they are incredibly clean, deliberate, and almost robotic with the way they produce their content. Through doing research for this video, I came to the understanding that the massive economic success of Tasty and even BuzzFeed is a topic that has been touched on quite a bit. I'll do my best to summarize what these mini articles say while also offering some internet culture insight to show that what it is trumps all other sources of information. Basically, BuzzFeed is a company that has roughly 1,700 people working for it, and since an estimated half of their revenue comes from Tasty, and Tasty is the fastest growing branch of BuzzFeed, we can assume hundreds of employees work to produce this content. Because of this, the brand is able to churn out videos at an absurd rate. But what's really interesting about the massive staff that sits behind these videos is the intense levels of research that have gone into and continue to go into perfecting viral videos. As mentioned earlier, everything in the typical Tasty video is designed. An interview with one of their chief content producers demonstrates that Tasty aims to maximize the shareability of their videos while taking every aspect of design into account. It's said once a video has been filmed and edited, a 75-person team can effectively predict how well a clip will do, all before it's even posted. And while this might seem ridiculous at first glance, it makes sense given the money behind this venture, as the total populations reached by these videos rivals the audiences drawn in by the Super Bowl. As a result, Tasty and their small army of creators have broken down the perfect elements to the quick DIY food video, synthesizing them together into these 40 to 60 second masterpieces, all while turning their video creation process into a factory line of viral content. At the end of the day, the concepts behind Tasty are quite admirable, as they strive for a level of perfection and efficiency not often seen in the realm of online content, and by most measures they seem to have achieved it. Hopefully through explaining some of the elements of their audio and visual design, use of personality, and underlying concepts, we gave you a general idea of why Tasty works. We hope you enjoyed this video, but we actually aren't done yet. We have a few words to say to anyone interested in hearing a bit more about the goals behind Whatitis. Now, we ourselves haven't always been ultra supportive of BuzzFeed. In fact, if anyone closely watched our 10k subscribers video, they would have seen that we actually dissed them. This is because we, as an on-the-rise online media brand, want to challenge BuzzFeed, the current dominating force of mainstream internet content. This video is going to be the first of many attempting to expose and explore the techniques and ideas behind BuzzFeed which they've used to amass their following. In a way, we're declaring this war on BuzzFeed, hoping that we can educate people to make more informed decisions about the content they consume, ultimately establishing ourselves as the antithesis of BuzzFeed. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.